Cynthia Chaporia, and I'm a member of the ACC's Board of Trustees, and I'm an interventional cardiologist from Newport Beach, California. I'm happy to be here at TCT, and I'm going to talk to you about the ABSORB trials. At TCT, there are three ABSORB trials that are going to be presented. The four-year data for the ABSORB 2, the three-year data for ABSORB 3, and ABSORB 4. And so the ABSORB trials, as you know, is a comparison of the bioresorbable vascular scaffold stent versus a drug-eluting stent. The original ABSORB trial was the ABSORB 2 trial, which had about 501 patients. It was not a U.S. trial, and they compared the bioresorbable vascular scaffold with a drug-eluting stent, and what they found was a twofold increase in the device-related clinical events. And so we had more target vessel myocardial infarction, as well as increased risk in the stent thrombosis and scaffold thrombosis. The second ABSORB trial is the ABSORB 3 trial, which was a U.S. pivotal study. And the two-year data from this trial was presented at ACC 2017. And what they found was that there was an increase in the target lesion failure. And this was driven by the target vessel myocardial infarction and the scaffold as well as stent thrombosis, which was almost twofold in that study. At TCT, what they presented is the three-year data. And once again, we see an increase in the target lesion failure and again an increase in the target lesion myocardial infarction as well as stent and scaffold thrombosis rate. And actually that stent thrombosis rate at 3 years was 2.3% versus 0.6%. So the last ABSORB trial is the ABSORB 4 trial, and in that it's about 2,600 patients were included, and they expanded the patient population to include patients that had a troponin positive non-ST acute coronary syndrome. But they still did not include patients with CTOs, left main, or complex lesions. And again, they looked at target lesion failure at 30 days. And this was a non-inferior trial. And what they found was that it was non-inferior with regards to target lesion failure at 30 days. Now, they are going to be looking at the target lesion failure at 1 year. They're going to be looking at it between 3 to 7 to 10 years. And that is going to be a landmark analysis looking at combining the data from ABSORB 3 as well as ABSORB 4. Now, they also, one of the other interesting things about ABSORB 4 is that they try to use the lessons that they learned from ABSORB 3. And one of the things that came out at, in March at the ACC meetings was the fact that this whole notion that maybe this technology would work better if the vessels were not so small. So in this ABSORB 4, they discouraged utilization of the bioresorbable vascular scaffold in arteries that were less than 2.5 millimeters. So that was one change. The other thing is that there was a lot of discussion with the ABSORB 3 data about PSP pre-dilatation, appropriate sizing, and post-dilatation. And so they encouraged the PSP in ABSORB 4 to look at that. So all we have is a 30-day TLF data right now. We're going to be looking for the long-term data. But again, the early data so far indicates that maybe we're not quite where we need to be with the technology and the bioresorbable scaffold, and that maybe we need more standardized technique in terms of the PSP.